else to students when I talk about fossils is that they're not just really, really, really cool things that we see in museums. They're important parts of the evolutionary history of the Earth. And very, very rarely will you find fossilized skin or fossilized tissue or fossilized hair. You can find remnants of it, you can find casts of it, but you very rarely find the actual stuff. So you have to find these areas that have been geologically stable. When you find the fossils in tomorrow, those fossils that you find, if they're in the water, the fresh water, for too long, they disintegrate.
So now we're in the Big Brook Preserve in Colts Neck, Monmouth County, and we're going to be doing some fossil hunting in the Big Brook, which over the eons of prehistoric and history, geological history in New Jersey, is known to have lots of fossils. Because of the many different formations and sediments and periods of earth materials that have been in this area. I'm excited. I got my trowel. What do they call this?
Trowel.
Trowel. These are my awesome
field boots.
Field boots. I call them now since my beginning in the field research in Costa Rica 2 years ago. So I'm excited. It looks like we're coming up along the book now. So we're going to be going in, walking through it. Now I got the camera on you. Did you find anything yet?
I have no idea. I think it's a lot of rocks.
This could be something.
You didn't study your sheet that I gave you last time?
I watched the Olympics. As soon as I get home,
this is it. Yeah, this is wet park.
Oh.
Stream is slowly cut this down. We're down into like 65 million year old territory. Mm.
This was coast at some point.
Right.
And now we're finding that. I'm not sure if it's just a really smooth down rock because we have this machine.
Right.
That's the bottom half of one of your prehistoric oysters.
Cool.
So that's fabulous.
Now you recommend the edges?
Okay, well, let's think about this. Okay, you're a little fossil.
Right.
And you're in a moving water environment.
Right.
Where would you finally drop out of the water flow?
In the slowest part, which would be on the edges.
So like when you find a little dip, a pool. Now again, the rules are only sampling from within the water line in the stream bed. Do not go digging up there, number one, because it's going to exacerbate any more erosion. Plus number two, the stream has already done all the work. Mm. Anything up in those layers, you know, at some point we'll get washed down here, so it's a lot. So again, a lot of it's just patience.